We have that x is greater than 0, and we have to check which of following inequalities must be true. Must be true. It means for every number greater than 0, these inequalities are true. So let's start from the first inequality. Let me copy this example. We have 2x minus 1 is greater than 0. Because we have here word must, it means this inequality must be true for all x is greater than 0. So it will be enough if we find one example for which this inequality is not true. So let's see what we can take for x. X must be greater than 0. But because we have here first 2x minus 1 on the left side must be greater than 0, if I take that x is 1 half, for example, so what I will have here, let me do this. Write this first, x is equal 1 half. I can take x is equal 1 half because x must be greater than 0. 1 half is greater than 0. So I can take this fraction. And now what I will do? I will substitute to our inequality x by 1 half. So we have 2 times 1 half. I substitute x by 1 half. Minus 1 we copy must be greater than 0. Let's check. 2 times 1 half is 1. 2 and 2 we can reduce. So we have 1 minus 1 is greater than 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 is greater than 0? No, it's not true. So we found one number for which our inequality is not true. Because we have word here must. So this inequality should be true for all x is greater than 0. But we found one example for which this inequality is not true. It's enough to find only one example. You don't have to look for more examples. When you find one and it shows you that this inequality is not true, this is the end. We show that this inequality is not true for all x's greater than 0. So, first, inequality is not true. We can write. Let's do next. So this was first. Next, we will take the second inequality. We have negative x squared plus x is less than 0. Again, because we have given that x must be greater than 0, so we have to choose one number greater than 0. And if this number will not give us true inequality, it means that this inequality is not true for all x is greater than 0. So let's do this. We need to find one example only. It will be enough. So let's take that x. Because we have here negative sign and positive sign. And when we take 1 to second power, it will be still 1. So let's take x is equal 1. You can choose different number, but this calculation will be very easy for x equals 1. So now we substitute to our inequality x's by 1. So we have negative sign, and now I will put in parentheses 1. I substitute x by 1, and we have to take this 1 to second power plus, and we have x, so will be plus 1. We have to check if this is less than 0. What we have? Negative sign we copy. 1 to second power is 1 plus 1 we copy. So negative 1 plus 1 is 0. So we have 0 is less than 0. No, it's not true. 0 is equal to 0. So we found one example for x equal 1. Our inequality is not true. So we can write that the second inequality is also not true. For all x is greater than zero, because we found one example. It's enough always to find only one example. You don't have to look for more. And the third inequality, we have x squared is greater than 1. So we have to choose x greater than 0. So the easiest example, what will be? For example, we can take x equal 1, x equal 1 half, 1 eighth, it doesn't matter. We have a lot of numbers which you can choose. It's enough if you show one number this inequality is not true, because we have here word must be true. For x greater than 0, for x, all x is greater than 0, this inequality should be true. If you show one example, it's enough to show this inequality is not true. So let's take for example now that x is equal 1 over 4. So we will substitute x by 1, 4. We have 1, 4. 2 second power should be greater than 1. Let's see. 1, 4 to second power is 1 over 16. This is greater than 1? Of course not. This is less than 1. So this inequality is not true for x equal 1 over 4. We found one example for which our inequality is not true. What it means? That this inequality is not true. This is my solution.